All right. Hello, everybody. It is Coach Seth, your coach of the Atlanta Braves, bringing to you IBA Season 3 Draft Analysis. So, we were lucky enough to be invited into the IBA by the commissioner himself, Slightly Salty, who's also the commissioner of the RCF. And they're like, hey, you want to join the IBA? And I was like, hell yeah, I want to join the IBA. I've been a fan of this league for basically as long as I've known one of my good buddies in Draft League, who's Q. My name's Q. You can find him down in the description below, along with all the other coaches of the IBA. So I've known him for a long time. I've known him for 5 months. And I checked today because I wanted to see how long my draft analysis for the DPC was been up, because that's basically how long I've known him. So I've been a fan of this league ever since then, basically, because he uploaded it. And even if not, then it's like a little bit after I've met him. So almost like around 5 months, basically. And I'm just excited to be a part of it. The logos fired, the draft analysis slides are absolute heat. Shout out to JV, and just wait until you see the layout. Oh my god. But anyways, so the IBA is a YouTuber league, much like the RCF, so you can find everyone and their links down in the description below. And this is going to be our draft analysis for the league. So, basically, it was a standard point draft this season, so there were tiers ranging from 18 points to 1 point. So there were 18 tiers, and you had only 120 points, I believe, to draft Pokemon. I believe it was somewhere around that area. And I had like 120 points to draft a Pokemon, a team of 11 Pokemon. And, you know, how draft works, you take those Pokemon, you build a team each week for your opponent, and then you throw down. So I was actually able to get the third spot of the overall draft. Shout out to Salty for that one, because he was originally the third overall. I was third to last, I think. And I've been teasing Q that I'm gonna get his Dragapult, and I was like, no, I can't get his Dragapult. Once I saw that I was like third to last, and then it's like Salty was like, you want to switch? I'm low-key down to switch. And so we switched, and now I got third of the overall draft. And so you kind of know what that means, but is there anything else left to say about this? I don't know. Let's just get into the draft analysis in the month that we were able to pick up. So, round one, to no one's surprise, it's Dragapult. Dragapult is an amazing mod. Like, the seventh fastest mod, if not, like, the seventh, like, fifth to seventh fastest mod in the game. I know it's in that area. With base 142 speed. You are never running max speed Dragapult. What do you have to run for max? What do you have max speed Dragapult for? Like Zeraora? We don't have a lot that's allowed in this draft. A lot of the mons that are faster than him are like Zacian and all that kind of thing. But some of those aren't allowed in this. So the only things that I think I necessarily have to worry about that are faster are like Ninjask and Zeraora. And I think maybe the Ghost Horse that was announced in the Crown Tundra. I don't know how to pronounce its name. But Dragapult's an amazing mon. Amazing, amazing Pokemon with amazing coverage. Its attacking stats are absolutely beautiful, with a base 120 physical attack and then base 100 special attack. This thing is a both physical and special monster. It has like, amazing coverage, like I said, gaining access to Flamethrower, Thunderbolt, even Scald. Nobody runs Scald though. I could be the first. I don't think I've ever seen Scald ran on a Dragapult. But it doesn't get Poltergeist, which is a little upsetting, but it does get Phantom Force, which is actually still very common for Dragapult to run. Dragon Darts, Phantom Force, Dragon Dance, probably Steel Wing for some coverage. But other than that, this thing has amazing, it's like an amazing pivoter because it's so fast and it gets access to U-Turn. So it has amazing pivot options. It has status options with Thunder Wave and Will-O-Wisp. Does not get toxic, from what I can see. Yeah, no toxic. And this thing is overall just an amazing mon. It gets Infiltrator as one of its abilities, and Cursed Body, so if I'm ever feeling like being an asshole, I can run Cursed Body Dragapult. But most of the time, I'll probably be running Infiltrator to see if I can find some subsets that want to start setting up and have Dragapult just completely punish them, you know? Unless they're faster and they're like, you know, it's like a D-dancing, subbing Gyarados or something. You know, it's one of those types of things. But other than that, I don't know if there's much else to say about Dragapult. Dragapult's such an amazing Pokemon. Getting access to Will-O-Wisp, it also, like, has potential to, like, hex and things like that. So, you know, there's always that. But moving on. Our second pick of the draft is none other than Weavile. Weavile is a great mod. Weavile has recently been coming up as well. I know it's always been pretty good, but it's recently been coming up, gaining access to Triple Axel as of the Isle of Armor. Choice Banded Triple Axel does absolutely, like, it does an absurd amount of damage. It allows me to have access to Knock Off. It's such a fast Pokemon. It has base 125 speed, and it gets coverage for basically all of the things it's weak to, mainly like fighting types, for instance. It gets access to Psycho Cut, which I just saw, but I lost it. But the main set is like Choice Bandit, Triple Axel, Ice Shard, Knock Off, and Low Kick. All of those like really great moves, and like what it does, it really does best. Like, Weavile is such an amazing Pokemon. For fairy types, it has access to Poison Jab, gets access to Shadow Claw. You can do a Swords Dancing Weavile. I don't know if you'd want to, because Choice Banded Triple Axel already does enough for you. You know, it's one of those types of things. But like I said, gets access to Knock Off, which is actually really good. We can knock off some things going into games and things like that. X Scissor for some coverage, I guess, for some types of Pokemon. But being a dark type, it gives me an immunity to psychic type, which is actually a really nice thing to have. So Zen Headbutts aren't being completely spammed against my team and things like that. But I don't know much else to say about Weavile. It's like a really strong, really fast mod. It's very frail, though. It's pretty frail with base 65 and 85 defenses. So it's not necessarily the most defensive mod. It's definitely a glass cannon, because for sure, it's definitely a glass cannon. It gets access to Toxic, so that could be something, along with Taunt. Another thing that could potentially be happening is, you know, a taunting Weavile here and there. But other than that, I basically covered everything with Weavile. Like, Choice Banded Triple Axel, Knock Off, Ice Shard, Low Kick. That's an amazing set right there, and Weavile just uses that set so perfectly. So, moving on, we have Cinderace. Now, I do want to say, basically every single pick up until like pick 9, I was sniping someone, and I felt horrible about it. I felt so bad. Okay, but we got Cinderace. It cannot run Libero on Cinderace, unfortunately, am I right? But just because it doesn't have Libero doesn't mean it's a bad mod. It's an amazing heavy-duty boots user. It gets Court Change, so if people want to set Hazards and I don't have Hazards, oh, Court Changing Cinderace. Now your Hazards are my Hazards type of thing. But I do have Hazards, don't worry, I have Hazards. Has base 110 speed, base 116 attack, so a little difference you'll see in my drafting here. I'm actually drafting semi-fast Pokemon. I also think there was just an ad playing in the music. I didn't notice that. You probably noticed that, but there was an ad. Anyways, you know how YouTube is with their ads, but anyways, you know, Pyro Ball is such an amazing move, doing absolute damage to basically everything. It gets U-Turn, so it's also another pivot mon that can, you know, do some really good damage. Gets Sucker Punch. It gets Scorching Sands, but nobody runs special Cinderace. But I know that this thing can, like, run bulk up sometimes. Like, I've seen bulking up Cinderaces before that are pretty decent. Super Fang could also be some interesting move to run, cutting the target HP in half. So if you're at full and I Super Fang, you're now at 50. It's one of those things, and it's just really interesting to have. Also, if I have some priority on it too, that'd be pretty cool. Pretty cool, like strong priority, like Sucker Punch. That'd be an interesting set to run, maybe. Let's see. You know, Pyro Ball, like I said, is an amazing move. Has a 10% chance to burn the target. If something's frozen, it will thaw the user, which is a little unfortunate, but you know, it's all right. I'll probably still be doing damage, and you know, I get the one turn of freeze where you're not attacking me. Is that how that works? I don't know. But Pyro Ball is a base 120 move, and it's stab. Like, that's just, it's insane. And it only has a 10% chance of missing. And I know since I'm bringing up the missing percentage, that RNG is not going to be on my side. And I'm going to miss every single Pyro Ball now, because I brought up that it only misses 10% of the time. It's going to be missing 50% of the time for me now. But, you know, High Jump Kick, Pyro Ball, Iron Head, Zen Headbutt, Gunk Shot, Sucker Punch, Court Change, all really good moves that Cinderace can use. Like, I Bulk Up, like I said, could also be one. But this thing is honestly just a really, really great Pokemon. U-Turn, obviously, it's never a bad idea to run. Super Fang Taunt, it can access the Taunt. Never bad sets to run. So I'm really glad that I was actually able to pick it up. Cinderace is a great mon. I'm actually drafting semi-fast Pokemon, which is not even semi-fast, really fast Pokemon, which is basically out of the ordinary for me, so it should be fun to explore some new battling styles. Now, moving on, we're going back to the bulk. We got Tangrowth. Tangrowth is literally one of the bulkiest mons in the game. I take it back. It's not one of the bulkiest mons in the game, but it's really bulky either way. With base 125 physical defense. We're not going to mention its special defense, but it has base 50 special defense, base 110 special attack, and base 100 attack with 100 HP. So this thing is a physical monster. I have seen some AV Tangrowths running around sometime. That's a thing. But this thing gets access to things like Giga Drain, Knock Off. I know Toxic and like Stunt Spore / Sleep Powder are pretty common. Giga Drain is actually really reliable recovery when it comes to Tangrowth, just because you have that base 110 and special attack stat, so it's not only stab and not only recovery, but it's going to be doing some damage to a decent amount of things. So nothing really wants to take this Giga Drain. It also gets Morning Sun if that's not super reliable. I know that like this thing can run Rocky Helmet, Leftovers. Regenerator is an amazing ability. I don't know why I haven't mentioned it yet. Regenerator is amazing. Basically, if I'm at low HP and I switch, I'm at fucking 50% now, and that's just a whole issue for some people. But like I said, sleep, it can run some status and be really good at that. Running status is really good for Tangrowth since it is a bulkier mon. It's mostly here. It's not necessarily here to dish out hits. It's more so here to take, like to take them, especially mostly on the physical side. Like I said, I have seen some AV sets running around before, so that could necessarily be a thing too. So it doesn't necessarily have to be only taking physical hits. It could potentially be taking some special ones as well. We just have to see where the chips fall. But Tangrowth, like I said, is just an amazing mon. Like Giga Drain and having Knock Off and Regenerator is just a beautiful thing to have with this thing. So, moving on, we drafted Heracross. Heracross gets access to spikes, which is pretty interesting. But I once got swept by a Bulk Up Megahorn Heracross. It was so bad. Especially since it was also Moxie. So every time it killed something, it would gain HP. Or not HP, raise attack. This thing gets Guts as well. Moxie and Guts are like an interesting combination of abilities, but it does open up the range of items we can run with this thing. Life Orb's a good item. Flame Orb's a good item because of Guts. So there's a lot of things we could do. There's some sub bulk up sets we could potentially run. I've been getting familiar with subsets just cuz and they're really good to run. This thing has a base 125 attack stat. Absolutely insane. It's clicking buttons right here. So I'm really excited. I've kind of wanted to draft Heracross before and never necessarily had the chance to. And now that I have the chance, I hope that I can like put in some work with it. It's such a good mod. it has a really good like ability, like, or typing I should say. Bug fighting is really good. It gets coverage for psychic types that want to comment on it. It's neutral to fairy types because bug resists fairy as well. For those of you who don't know, there's a new fact of the day. But it also gets access to knockoff as well, so that could also potentially be something. It could stone edge too for those flying types that it's four times weak against. You know, Swords Dance, Toxic, it's a really good Pokemon. It's a really good Pokemon, and I'm excited to have it on my team. Because I've been wanting to pick this up for a long time, whether it be Mega Heracross or regular Heracross. And so I'm glad that I have this. And like I said, it gets spiked. So it can be like an offensive spiker. It has that kind of potential. So it's a really cool Pokemon. It gets Bullet Seed too for a little bit of coverage in some areas. But that's about it with Heracross. There's not much else to say. So moving on, we have Tornadus Eye, my first form of hazard removal on the team. So it gets Prankster and Defiant, which are pretty, like, really good abilities. If I'm trying to run a offensive Tornadus Eye, I can run Defiant. If I'm trying to run like a defogging Prankster thing, that's then I'll run Prankster, obviously. But with that being said, like, this thing is like mostly here to defog. I know it can, like, you know, have very much like offensive presence. It gets access to a U-turn, so it has some pivoting options as well. It can knock off and such. It's a pretty decent mon. It's a decent mon, don't get me wrong. But for me, mostly it's on the team just to have that form of very reliable hazard removal with defog. Air Slash could also potentially be like some things I run. Knockoff obviously will be a thing I run. It gets access to Nasty Plot, so Nasty Plot, three moves could be a thing maybe. Heavy Duty Boots could be a thing I run on this thing. I've used Tornadus before, and it's mostly been a defogging mod. Whenever I used it, it was mostly for defogging. I know I'm kind of giving away strategies, but I don't know. I want to explore new things with new Pokemon. This thing has a base 111 speed stat and a base 125 special attacking stat. So it definitely has some offensive presence. And hopefully we get to explore that. I know this thing gets access to Focus Blast as well, if I'm not mistaken. Yes it does. So it gets access to Focus Blast. So like Hurricane Focus Blast, that's just missing potential. Blunder Policy Focus Blast, Focus Blast, Hurricane. I found it, guys. I found the set right there. That could actually be a thing. You never know. Yeah, that's basically it. You know, I'll outspeed everything at least plus one. But like I said, this thing gives Prankster and can defog. It can also set up with Prankster as well, so that could potentially be a thing. I was originally supposed to grab Grimmsnarl, and I wanted it for Prankster sub bulk up sets. I can do sub nasty sets, which would be pretty interesting to do, for in my opinion. I think it definitely has a lot of potential to be more offensive than most people take it to. Most people like may think compared to its Therian form counterpart. But with that being said, that's basically it when it comes to Tornadus. So moving on, we have Seismitoad. I have Seismitoad in the RCF, and it's not done anything. It hasn't come off the bench. Hopefully, it will eventually. But this thing will definitely be coming off the bench here. Seismitoad is a great mon. I know we have a Dracovish running around. Shout out to Kita Costa Rican. And I can say that because all of these draft analyses are going up at the same time. Go check out everybody's channels. A little plug for y'all. Did I spell Toad wrong? I did not. I thought I spelled Toad wrong. Anyways, I expect 25% of your revenue. Anyways, I'm kidding. That's a joke. Anyways, this thing gets access to Swift Swim, Water Absorb, and Poison Touch. All really good abilities. If something wants to run Rain against me, I have Swift Swimming Seismitoad. What do you have for Choice Banded Liquidation? There's another ad playing. YouTube. Why? Anyways, but obviously Water Absorb is the main move you want to be running. Like I said, there is Dracovish running around, so obviously I need a Water Absorb mon to counter that. And this is what Seismitoad is here to do. This thing gets access to Stealth Rocks. I know Stealth Rocks, Knock Off, Scald, fourth move is like pretty common. Stealth Rocks, Knock Off, Scald, and Toxic. Common sets right there. This thing has pretty decent defenses at base 75 each. I know this thing, and a base 105 HP stat. So it's pretty good defensively. It can be either special or physical. It just depends on where you want to put your EVs. Leftovers is a great item for this mon. It has a base 95 attack stat, so if I really feel myself and I want to run an offensive Seismic Toad, I can run an offensive Seismic Toad with Life Orb or Choice Band. You know, it's one of those things. I probably won't ever do that, but it's an option. It's never not an option. But like I said, Stealth Rocks, Toxic, Knock Off, and Scald are basically amazing things that this thing does. Nobody really wants to lose their item on a mod, and nobody really wants to be toxic either. Or burn, depending on whether or not, like, there's a steel type, I have burn potential as well. So, that's basically it with Seismic Toad. So, moving on, we have Galarian Weezing. So, my Fire, Water, Grass core is Cinderace, Tangrowth, and Seismic Toad. So far, my Fairy Steel Dragon core is Dragapult and Weezing, an amazing core. Weezing can take fairy type hits if something wants to, like, try to hit Dragapult, like Scarfed Gardevoir. I don't even know if Gardevoir was drafted, but I know Scarfed Gardevoir can outspeed a max speed Dragapult by a couple of points. And I know that because I prepped for a Dragapult once with the Gardevoir. Anyways, this thing is taking all types of fairy moves. It's poison and fairy. It gives me access to T-Spikes, and it also gains access to Defog. For those of you who didn't know, there's your special fact of the day. This thing gets Defog, which is actually really interesting. But I know the sets that most people run are like Toxic Spikes, probably Defog, or what I'll be probably most likely running here and there are like Toxic Spikes, Defog, Strange Steam, fourth move. It gets access to Aromatherapy, so it can be a little, what is the word I'm looking for? A little supportive with Aromatherapy. This thing is really good defensive physically, like physically. It's 120 defense and base 65 HP, so it's not the best. This thing I feel like could also take some special hits because it has base 70 special defense, so it's not the worst thing in the world. If things want to try to set up in front of this thing, it gets access to Clear Smog. It gets access to Pain Split as well. So a little bit of recovery plus your mon getting damaged is always a nice thing. It gets Flamethrower and Thunderbolt. No water move or ice move. But there's not much else to say. Like, it's Toxic Spikes. It has Defog. It has, like, the Flamethrower Thunderbolt that I just said. Strange Steam, which can potentially confuse people. Pain Spit's really, well, not really good recovery, but decent recovery when it comes to this thing. Especially since it has a pretty low HP stat. And it has punishment for things that want to try to set up with Clear Smog. It won't ever miss a Toxic because it's a poison type and Aromatherapy, so it has supportive options. That's basically it with Weezing. I think it pairs really nice with what we have so far on the team, especially having, 2 to 3 mons weak to fairy types. Having something that resists four times resistant to it is always nice. But I think coming this pick, we're getting to our next resistant of steel or fairy types. Registeel. We drafted Registeel. Registeel gets access to Body Press now. Do I need to say more? This thing is better than Toxapex when it comes to special defense. I remember looking that up. Not as good as Toxapex when it comes to physical defense, but it's not far off. This thing gets access to Clear Body, which can, prevent people from lowering their stats. So if people want to try to lower its defense stat, it can't. And Light Metal. Obviously, I probably won't go burning Light Metal because I know Heavy Slam's a pretty common thing to run on this mon. So, this thing can set me Stealth Rocks. It can Toxic. I know Knock Off. I think it gets Knock Off, actually. Wait, does it get Knock Off? I thought it got Knock Off. It doesn't get Knock Off. I'm wrong. Stealth Rocks, Toxic. Body Press is going to be so much, so useful with this thing, because of how bulky it is on the physically defensive side. Iron Defense, Body Press, toxic stuff. Rex could be an entire set right there. Sub Iron Defense Body Press with maybe like some other fourth move. It has a lot of potential to be really... Body Press has a lot of potential with this mod. Heavy Slam has always been a pretty good move for Registeel to run because it's literally a hunk of steel. Like, why wouldn't you run Heavy Slam on this thing? So like Heavy Slam Body Press could be like the two moves with like Stealth Rock and Toxic, just because, you know, you gotta have an attacking move somewhere, or it's, you know, you're not gonna be able to get chip on your things. And this thing, I think, could definitely be one of those mons who can come in, get a toxic off, and then do a little bit of chip and switch out, you know, into like something's real chip. So like a Flamethrower or like a Fire Type Arm coming in, it can Body Press, get a little bit of chip off, or maybe Heavy Slam, depending on whether or not I'm good at predicting, which, as you guys know, I'm not the best. But, you know, this thing really is really good. I think it'll be really good at chipping down things. And it is a new mon introduced within the Isle of Armor along with Tornadus. So we got two mons from the Crown Tundra. Two mons introduced from the Crown Tundra. Welcome back. We missed you. But I think this can be a really good Pokemon, and I'm excited to use it because I've heard really good things about Registeel and its defensive. So, with that being said, let's get into our 10th pick, and there's a little explaining to do. I originally drafted Rotom Fan, but I did drop it for Hitmonchan. So, Rotom Fan's a good mon, but we are actually talking about Hitmonchan. But, because it's not effective until week 2, but I don't think I'm bringing Rotom Fan for week 1. Spoilers! We drafted Marowak. Anyways. I didn't want to just have, if you guys remember, it's still going on. LUT, I have 3 debuggers, and that's it for hazard removal. So if I'm setting hazards, and they set hazards, and I need to get rid of them, I have to get rid of my hazards in turn. And I didn't want that here. So, I drafted a spinner, which is Hitmonchan. It gets Iron Fist, so it can run, like, Close Combat, Fire Punch for coverage. It gets like coverage with like elemental punches like Thunder Punch, Ice Punch, Fire Punch. It also gets access to Mach Punch, so it has priority as well. So if I need priority, like Mach Punch, Close Combat, Elemental Punch, plus Rapid Spin, I can do that. That's a thing. I don't necessarily know what items come with Hitmonchan. Like, I don't know what items would be good to run on this thing. It's pretty, like, it's really good. Like defensively, with a base, well, especially that is with a base 110 special attack, special defense stat, and it's a base 105, base 105 attacking stat. And Rapid Spin will boost your speed, and there's all types of things you can do with this kind of mod. Gets, like I said, the elemental punches, so it has some pretty decent coverage. But mainly, it's here just to be a Rapid Spinner. It's not the best mon, if I'm being honest. But it has a lot of Rapid Spinning potential. It's a pretty reliable Rapid Spinner, and I'm excited to use it because I've used its counterpart with him on top, which I was originally supposed to draft. But I didn't. I should have known that it wasn't coming all the way to round 10, which was where I necessarily was. Where it was going to be drafted by me. But it got taken. I didn't expect it, like... How do I word this? I did expect it to get drafted, but you know, I was like, okay, if not, then I'm just gonna grab it because I've used Hitmontop before. It's a good mod. But yeah, this is a great mod. Hitmonchan, well, it's Hitmonchan's okay. Not as good as Hitmonlee or Hitmontop, in my opinion. It's the worst of the Hitmons. But with that being said, that's basically it. Like, it gets access to Mach Punch and priority, the elemental punches, Close Combat, and Rapid Spin. Rapid Spin's the big thing. Having removal is the big thing. So, moving on, we grabbed Marowak as our final Pokemon. I didn't know what else to grab, and like, I needed a Pokemon from like tier 3, which is like the tier that's worth only 3 points. This thing gets Thick Club, which will double its attacking stat, which is, you know, good because it only has base 80, which isn't bad, but it's not the best. This thing offers me an electric type immunity. Granted, I already had that with Seismitoad, but, you know, it gives me another. But I don't know what you say with this mod. It gets access to Stealth Rock. It has, like, toxic potential. It has I know it has its own move, like Bone Meringue, right? Yeah, Bone Meringue, which is a 50 base power move and hits 2 times, so it's a 100 base power move, plus the Thick Club can be doing some decent damage to things. For some reason, it gets, like, decent special coverage, like with Flamethrower and Ice Beam. Don't know why, but, you know, it is what it is. This thing gets access to Knock Off, so it gives me another Pokemon that can knock off as well. But that's about it. Like, Marowak is a decent mon. It's a decent low tier mon, don't get me wrong, but I just needed something on the team. So, like, Boomerang, Knock Off, other move, Sword Stance, I know. That's a, like a set when it comes to Alolan Marowak. I don't know how well it functions on regular Marowak, but we'll find out together because I can definitely see this putting in some work in specific areas. But with that being said, that's actually going to be the close of my draft analysis for the IBA Week 1. Will go up next week at 7. Also, be on the lookout for tomorrow for LET playoffs and RCF Week 3. I had an amazing match for week 3 of RCF, an amazing match. Don't know about LET playoffs yet, because I haven't played playoffs yet. I was supposed to, didn't end up happening. But with that being said, I'm going to get up on out of here. I'm Coach Scythe, your coach of the Atlanta Braves. Be on the lookout for this league. I'm super excited. Thank you for the people in the IBA for allowing me to join your ranks. Hopefully, I don't crack under the pressure of being the new guy and I'm able to persevere and, you know, just be on the top. So with that being said, like, I'm gonna get up on out of here for real this time. I'm Scythe, your coach of Atlanta Braves. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you.